Hey everyone, it's me again, and tonight I actually prepared something. Some tea, and a lot of paint. I poured the tea first because even though I have it prepared, it will probably still take me by surprise, as it always does. Might take a while, so cheers. Grab yourself something to drink. I will probably forget all about my tea until I am done, or maybe not. I have two sets of colors here, and I was inspired by several people who did bottle pours, and so I picked my paints. Yes, I mixed my paints very thin. Well, this one is extremely thin because so thinner than I would usually do. And I didn't put any silicone in any of the paints either. So my two sets consist of, one has only two browns and copper, and black and white go in both. And the other one has a variety of blues, some grey, gold, and gold ochre. Yeah. And they made me think of eye colors, so the puddle pours might create rings, so perhaps I will make something that resembles an eye. Before I started acrylic pouring way back when I still used to paint frequently, I often drew eye shapes. I still draw eye shapes, but I also often painted eye shapes. An oval with pointed almond shape. You know what eyes look like? That shape. I do not think I have enough space on my table. Oh, and I just did a little test with the colors that I have. But I blew them out just to see. They still give me cells, some cells, which is totally fine, by the way. Just wanted to see if it didn't give me anything ugly. It didn't, so. I am planning to try and keep the eye shape, but who knows what happens, because I also really like this. So, we will see what happens when I get going. I think I'll have to move some of these paints off this tiny improvised table of mine, because otherwise it's never gonna work. This Prussian blue here is water thin. I did add more Floetrol and to make it a bit thicker even. This is what was left in the bottle, and what was the rest of what was still in the bottle mixed with some pouring medium and a bit of water. So, yeah, let's see if that still works. Should be enough pigment in there to do something at least, but can't be sure. I have a, what is this size? 24 by 30, I think. Well, I have this canvas here. Prepared, and let's see how this goes, shall we? Oh, and the grey also has it. The grey is just black and white mixed together, obviously. And I put some silver in it, or no, I didn't. I put some silver in this one, which is actually a darker blue mixed with white. A little bit of white and lighter blue, not sure, just a variety of shades of blue and a bit of silver. I don't know if you can see that on camera. I can see it here, it has a bit of shimmer in it. Do, 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 do. Okay, let's see if I can leave these here. If you think, what's that shining through? I just put the date on the back. So that's what you see. Black goes in last. I'm very curious how this will go. I'm contemplating if I should put my... Oh, I just tested my table and it's level. So, well, at least my it's a grocery crate. On this side of the table, it's completely level. So if I keep it here, it shouldn't go anywhere. Let's just put it down like this then. Yeah, okay. Because on this side, it's minus 2%, I think. So that might be enough to make it go haywire. Make all the paint flow off. I'm gonna fill the canvas with white first, just because I want it to flow easily, as if it wouldn't already. I have some more white too. Started out great, then I thought no. Also, this isn't enough. First time, because this is the first time I'm trying this kind of pour. I thought I would do it on a smaller one, an 18 by 24, but I reconsidered and I thought, what if it does turn out nice? Because I really like this color combination, and even if it doesn't look like eyes or anything, I think that I still might really like it. And 18 by 24 is really small. It feels smaller than a 20 by 20 somehow, because it's rectangular. I also have these thingies, and I want to see if they keep the paints, if I can store the paints in them for a while without them drying out completely. So I'm just trying that out with the white that I will have left. See, what it does, because I have a couple of these containers and then I can use those for that as well. And to think that all the other paints are even more fluid than this. Really curious. I'm also hoping that because the white is a little bit thicker, it will keep the paint from just running off the canvas instantly. And also, because the paint will have to work through the white a bit to get through the white, it might create some nice blooming, or might have a nice effect. Who knows? I don't. You don't either. We will see what happens. Okay, come on. Get over here. I'm going to torch this before I start, because there are some bubbles. Oh, paint on the wall. It's white paint, white wall. Good. Go cover up the blue and gray spots that are on there already. I got myself a new one of these today because this is exciting. I'm very curious what will happen. Are you too? YouTube? You curious too? I'm not sure if anyone is watching my videos. I'm just mostly talking to myself, and I'm totally fine with that, by the way. I'm only just starting out, so I don't expect anyone to look to me as an example. Let's close that box of white before I drop anything in it. That might be a bad idea. Okay. I'm gonna start out with that blue because I'm really curious to see what that will do. Ooh, maybe I'll take a no because that's gonna. No, I'm just gonna pour it. I do hope that I will be able to keep it from dripping. Won't be the worst thing in the world. I see already a cool, nice ring, but it's not very round. Oh well. That's fine. Okay, what order did I just put this in? I do have a lot of the Prussian, but I don't have a lot of most of the other colors. Then some gray. This is actually, this color combination is based on my own eye color, by the way. My eyes have interesting colors. They are bluish, gray, bluish. Sometimes they seem green when I'm wearing green, mostly. And in the middle they have this, well, I always say it's a golden ring around the iris, but it's probably just some yellowish light brown, God knows what. But hey, I have gold paint, so I'm not afraid to use it. Is that enough of that? I don't know. And then that gold ochre. I didn't want to put that immediately into the light blue because then it would go green on me. And my eyes sometimes seem grey, but they are in fact not. So. And then black in the middle. This is not very round at all. Well, let's see what we get. It is a puddle of paint. Oh, it almost looks like a peacock feather a bit. Look at that. That's cool. Okay. I can go over that. Okay, let's put the other colors on. I thought that I would start with the darkest brown. Is Van Dyke brown. And then I'll put the copper in. I think might give a nice layer in between the browns because when I just tested it, put them on the browns on top of each other and they didn't really show the difference. So thinking this probably isn't in there, but tiny bit of this, tiny amount of that, and then some more Van Dyke brown. And then I want a lighter shade of brown. Tiny cup. It's easily done, of course. Brown. Where's that white? Okay. titanium white, so that's not too much in it. Otherwise, I get too light. See, that's already quite light. That's what you get with titanium, I suppose. Bulletproof. Not materials. Ricochet. Take your ring. I like the shape of this one better, but I'm going to tilt it anyway, a bit, I think, just very, very, very slowly. Round and round. Copper is dominating. Should have waited to tilt mine until I... lesson learned. The blue one, I mean. They're both mine. Should have waited to tilt it until I poured both on. Swirl, swirl, swirl. Oh. It's gonna run off anyway. It's fine. I love those browns. Wow. And now the grey is flowing in to there. This is just gonna be abstract. I do want some more blue because now it's one grey blob. Very flowy gray blob. And blobs can be nice, but I don't want a gray one. No. Let's put a little light in there. Also, then, now that I'm pouring more paint on, thinking whether it would be a good idea to swipe something or maybe draw something out. With a pointy thing or a fork. In real life I would not advise anyone to put forks in eyes, but this is not really, these are not really eyes, don't worry. It's just paint. Is this smart? Probably not, but I'll just okay. And a drop here too. Just because I can. Now I'm just playing with paint. My favorite colors. I'm playing with them. I want one of those. Where are they? These. Are we still in focus, by the way? I hope we weren't out of focus the whole time. If so, I'm very sorry. This gives me a little more control over the where the paint lands. And gives me an option to okay, let's save that for later. I love splattering, but maybe this is not the right time for it. Hold on. I'm feeling like I want a bit of white in the color as well. Ooh, this white needs a bit thinning. Needs some thinning, otherwise it's much thicker than the other ones. That won't work, probably. That squeeze bottle only gives you a few drops every time you use it, so you don't thin it too much instantly. Okay. Oh. There is a hair on my glove. Do not want you on my painting. Get off. Okay, let's have a sip of tea before I do anything. I hate when my tea gets cold. I like drinking my tea quite hot, and when I just become a mother, one thing that I noticed that almost all of my tea got forgotten, and my hands were full, so I couldn't drink it. Full of baby, of course. So my tea would run cold. And most moms that I encountered would be able to relate to this phenomenon. All of a sudden, your tea always, you never drink warm tea anymore. Almost never, and when you do, it feels like a real luxury. Because the paint is so thin, it runs down so easily, but it also mixes up a bit and just gives me these tiny little stripes here. What I do like is that the copper has blended into the bluish tones over there, over here, and here too. They've sort of run into each other. Ooh, and here some, there's some subtle greenish tones starting to appear, which is fine as long as it's subtle and as long as it's not all over the canvas. Unless I'm making a green painting. What does this look like? What does it look like? It has a huge glare. I didn't torch the bubbles out again. I forgot. Okay. use the white again. Ouch. Without my skin between. Let's see. Straw. Some cells are forming. Can't help themselves. I'm happy to see that my paint isn't really flowing without me tilting the canvas, so the table is indeed leveled. Oh, let's torch some bubbles out. I just said that I didn't, so let's do it now then. Let's see what else happens. I might have done that earlier. But it didn't. Oh, I just pulled off the paint from my table in one large piece earlier, almost completely. Yeah, I spread out all the paint that I had left from the last time when it was still wet, hoping that it would dry quickly, which it did, because the film paint was quite thin. I'm gonna leave this one here because it's so thin and oh no. Oh, it is running. I'm gonna get down from my step stool here. Okay, my head will be in the way. Which it still might be. Going off the table, people. I was so focused, I forgot to check it out. Funny, I usually make abstract art in one way or another, and it's funny how I often surprise myself by thinking of, like, for this I had eye colors in my head, and for some other project I had a flag, colors of a flag, and it's funny how I'm surprised that it actually doesn't turn out to look like an eye or a flag, while obviously not, because it's abstract, so what do you expect? It's kind of funny. Or I'm just really stupid, that's also a possibility. Let's consider it cute. By the way, I love what's happening there. This is completely different from anything I've made so far. And also, I'm noticing I have some actual negative space here. So some white left on my canvas. Wow. For how long, no one knows. But for now, negative space. Wow. It's not good. Okay, easy now. Oh, paint. Saliva. Paint again. Good. Oh, watch out what you're doing. Okay. Was some peppermint. Don't worry, didn't break a tooth. Why are some parts of my canvas still not covered in white? How is this possible? Probably because I put my finger on it. That's not pure white. There you go, canvas. No, that's not the way to go. That's a lazy way to go. You want good coverage. You want good coverage. It's like insurance. Sucks if you don't get good coverage. And what did you pay for? No. Nothing. Oh. If you have back problems, I really recommend sitting on your knees slightly raised and tilted forward over a canvas. It's really, really very painful. And I have a straw in my mouth, so it sounds like, I don't know. Okay. This is what I have. I like the edges. This is a bit messy. Too many colors running through each other. There's a lot of copper already. Yeah, let's not put more copper on. We can add some more brown. All of it on there immediately, shall we? Some white, which I can then proceed to blow over it. Don't worry, it'll blow over. And a bit of black. See? Why not? I have this gray here. I could do something with that, but let's see what happens first with this. The gaps keep where I blew the paint away, it just paint runs back in because it's so thin, which is fine. Ooh, which is fine because now something interesting is happening here. Okay, it'll give you a minute to paint. Show me what you got. Yeah, I meant paint over here, not over there. The paint's gonna get it. Yeah, I know what I just said. Must not tilt too much. Ooh, blueing, yes,